Yeah, the fourth player is actually going to be Patrick Wessels, experienced tournament player,
Well, third
but
and second tier,
not a good
five player,
FCRX player.
four player, yeah.
To
I see what I can do there.
I mean, not particularly a good FCRX player, but
Sleepy
a
has
player
your
with
bet.
that knows the basics, knows what he's doing. Let's see. I'll be commentating the final.
Oh, white lentil.
Flower day, yeah.
Oh, white lentil, just don't press any buttons. Just stay at the start line.
Wait for everyone to die and you win
the
game. Good point, Arthur.
Is it Paul 60? No, it's Paul B. This?
It's Paul B.
Yeah.
Who's gonna sit where?
You play four, so you're on that side.
Oh, yeah, also.
Capture format. Probably lower. 640, 480, I'm guessing. Of course, I didn't press apply. Ah, here we are. This is not a speedrun, though. This is, let's see, no. How did you sort out GoldenEye in Exit Split? So yeah, Westu unfortunately could not make it. That would have been very epic. Then you would have three, four of the space flying kind. Now we have three. Yeah. How to fall on that? Yeah, we're not beginning just yet, but I'm going to be. Who's top left? Is Daniel top right? Down left. Not yet, not yet, guys. You can warm up if you want. I think we have enough to do all 24 tracks twice, actually. So. But don't start just yet, because I'm still adding the names. This might take a little bit of time. Yeah, this is warm up because I'm definitely not ready yet. Wout will be playing the top left. I think we have to get rid of the logo for this one. see all the space we can get. This is not the actual tournament just yet. Still making the preparations. Rooftop right, CGN. Up right. Yeah. One more. I think this should be bigger, 4-player feed. Maybe get rid of the web again. Or nope. Okay. We gaan gebruiken de Falcon Vestals. Je moet Tunnel Ritta gebruiken, joh. Hey. Dat is ook oké. I think we're about ready to go in. What? It does look a little messy, but okay. No, there will not be roulette for this segment, thank god, because that really can alter the results in a non-skilled way. It's not all we want. We just witnessed another race. 1730 miles an hour by Wouter Janssen. Alright. If you guys are ready, then we can reset and restart. Do you need to switch power off, or does it restart the counter right now? Yeah, power off first. Wouter's not on on screen. Needs to be a little further back. Yeah, okay. Well, Wouter's half on screen, but probably you want Wouter a little bit more to the. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. All right. Here we have the final event of NLG's official stream. Yeah, we can do the feed run later, but this is it for the official World Championship of Zero-X 2012. The versus race. We're gonna be doing all 24 tracks twice and add up the points at the end. This will be probably a stomach turner. We have dominant world champion Daniel Zia from Germany, who won the last high level meeting of F0X, so could be considered the reigning multiplayer world champion as well. Then we have Wouter Janssen, his biggest rival in both time trial, and he will be dangerous outsider to win this too. CGN from Norway, who is ranked 20th, but that speed differential is not that big, because in multiplayer you won't be seeing any of the sick time trialing strategies, so he will be able to keep up and probably score a few wins as well. And who knows, do even better than that. And then we have a fourth surprise contender in this match, Patrick Wessels, who's not ranked on MFO, but knows how to play F0X from old school Nintendo tournaments. So here we go. Let's go. Let's give it up. This is hype. Mute City 1. Yeah. Yeah, taking the early lead. Wouter just on his tail. It is perfectly possible to troll each other if you see that the other guy is going faster, to make a little budge and block them. So far, we have the players in order of their rankings lined up on New City 1. Vessel's lagging behind a fair bit already. But he's just gonna be focusing on playing his own races. See how far he will end up. Smooth sailing for Daniel. But the sun is being a troll again. Only gamers can be trolled by the sun. Risky energy management from all three top guys. Both Daniel and Wouter complaining about the sunlight. Not sure if we can do anything about that though, to be honest. We have sort of non-existent curtains. They are a step above the curtains we had last year in Andy, but we're making progress. We have 30 viewers now, the lucky 30, because this is this is height. Will Wouter go for Patrick is gonna go for some pushing, it seems. Be aware of the first few meters of Patrick. Pulling out the new strategies. CGN taking the lead. CGN actually the only ballsy guy of these four. Will his strategy pay off? Starting with a rail slide, taking an early lead. Both Daniel and Wouter on jumper settings are considered a bit safer. Patrick actually already in a chanceless position, doing a little crowd entertainment with a reversal camera. So there's room for high level entertainment and troll jokes, ladies and gentlemen. And this SRX World Championship. Daniel taking the lead. Implying CGN's glider strat did not pay off. Did not pay off yet, I should say. Wouter screwed it up actually, yes. CGN took over. Excellent performance of the glider strat. Daniel, oof. He's heading for the wall for a bit. Oh, wow! Patrick trolling Daniel. Big time. Can he gain the win like that? What the fuck? Pay attention to that guy. He's getting second place like that. Mario is shaking his head. He's adding an element of... He does get second place. Not sure if you want that actually. But well. Actually successfully killing them as well. Should pay attention to the fourth player's queen in the next rounds. It's gonna add an extra element of tactics. Avoiding the big black hole troll. It's going to be an element in the SRX World Championships. Not sure if that's what we want, but alright. We'll have to make do for now. Daniel actually securing that win already. But denied. He's not going to be too happy about that one. Wouter flying off fourth place, shaking his head. And now they're gonna make fun of him, because it is possible to dodge on both tracks easily. You can just drive on the top. Patrick doing his best to troll as hard as he can, but this was not enough. Daniel, confident win, 1:14 is actually not a bad time at all, I should say. Again, third place to Wessels, yes. Did I see correctly that CGN is in the lead so far? Well, that was because of the silence disaster, of course. Well, both Daniel and Wouter were trolled by Patrick on silence, so CGN is in the lead. All 24 tracks twice. Format. Actually, it seems that P.I. Lemierre is rooting for Wessels, not sure why. Third place. CGN in the lead. Doing well so far, surprisingly well. Well, it's not a... You are up against number one and number two monsters. So he's doing really well. Good stuff. From Norwegian's F0X champion, I think. Wow, this is a nail biter right here. Daniel and Wouter with some antics. Beware of the troll in the final lap, guys. He's waiting in the tunnel. Oh no, Daniel. Daniel and CGN destructing. This has nothing to do with Patrick getting a second place and my face is in shambles. Oh dear. CGN deserved to win that one, says someone in the stream. I tend to agree. Players should avoid crashing at all costs. He's just racking up the points. No, he actually switched to a non-troll vehicle for this course. Thank God. He's still up to his trolling wave though. Well, we see some demises here again. Big Blue, high crash rate. Daniel off to an awesome start with a jumper to Norita. Wow, nice chicane. Wouter in second, CGN following closely in third. Daniel seems home free. Excellent Big Blue performance so far. Nothing more to say. Even if Wouter and CGN pull out all the stops, they will not be able to catch him at this point anymore. Again, the troll coming up. Wouter and CGN, beware in the chicane. Both players got around. Conservative finish from Daniel Zia, and who can you blame him? No, you can't. Track hack terror posting represent Netherlands. Yeah, we're really proud of this one. What a photo finish, actually. CGN edging out Wouter by 0.03 seconds. That is wow, just wow. Might as well have slot machines if one person is going to troll. Yeah, that's true. Port down. Well, Daniel's getting new world records on this track earlier today, so he's off to a fucking monster start. Should be careful with explosives. Sorry about that. CGN. Doing very, very solid stuff. Holy shit. Daniel has to race his very best, get past TGN. Nobody got caught by the troll this time. Final lap. TGN following Daniel by 2 seconds, pulling off a very risky dive at the end, but... Wouter so far off to a slow start. Cannot be happy with how this first cup went. Let's resume the scores after this cup. Daniel in the lead. 20 points, CGN 15. Not sure about the other two. Went too fast. Sector Alpha. Wouter and Daniel also have body now. Crazy bear. Once again CGN. Seemingly go for the most ballsy vehicle. Trying the dive and crashing. Well, you needed to win. Once again a point for Vessels. Will try to throw himself into gaining more points. Daniel pulling off the dive again, as well as Wouter. Daniel having much more speed at the end though. Oh dear! Oh dear! Makes this race interesting though. Actually. Madness, this is turning into battle mode instead of racing, and Vessels is shut down, and rightly so. Wouter Janssen with the sculpt. He is a bit scary. But the track's coming up, it can be more easily be avoided. I'm pretty sure this is not what they wanted in the final. The Black Bull troll, but whatever. That's the new dynamics. It can make a race that seemingly is already over, have some unexpected developments. Daniel landing on Wouter's nose and his dive there. Really solid performance from Daniel so far, though, I have to say. Consistently leading. Just a little faster on those dives. Troll coming up. not sure where he is actually. Oof! Daniel actually got distracted, I think, by dodging the Black Bull asshole. First win for Motor, is it? Oh, two wins for Wouter actually. So you are second. Yeah, okay. Petrol. The worst part about this is that he actually doesn't even care. He just, I think he even likes this. Yeah, in hindsight, you might have been right, Marius. If I knew this beforehand, I would have stepped in. But oh well. It's just something they're gonna have to deal with. Maybe we can consider swapping him for the second set. probably not, though. Both going to try space flying. Interesting. Daniel pulling off a slightly faster dive in the lead. See Jen second, Wouter third. It's a troll picking his location carefully. Yes, he is. It should be hard to avoid at this speed. Careful approach by Wouter. Excellent. Excellent. Still one more lap to survive. Daniel in the lead, Wouter in second, but everything can still be lost with Patrick parked in the chicane. Daniel was laughing. I think he is in control. A little slower, just a little more careful. Spinning, yeah, wise idea, wise idea. That's how you deal with it. Knows what to do. Wow. Oh no, oh no! Damn it, damn it, damn it. They actually seem to be enjoying it a little bit though, so that's reassuring. CGN is gonna be sour about that one, I think, but he will maybe have his revenge by killing him later, who knows. Wouter managed to shut him down on Sector Alpha, and that was a victory for the skill. I like the skill side winning most of the times. He's picking on CGN. Why? CGN might be in dire straits, low health. Same goes for Wouter. Daniel flying off. I've won against good F0X runners, Petrol NLG 2012, yeah. Well. Oh wow. He's picking some assholish locations right there. Daniel will have to be careful in the final lap, he knows this. Same counts for Wouter. I think he can fly over him. He can fly over him. Pretty sure. Yeah. Oh wow! Nice move! Daniel actually. Oh wow! Daniel pulling off a space dive 360. Mad props to Daniel avoiding the troll. Wouter actually. 35, 7 victories for Daniel, starring in the show so far. Wouter will have to be fuming about that one, probably. doesn't seem too happy. Maybe we can donate later for a troll free after our next tournament. This is what I'm considering at the moment. Oh, Daniel tried a risky diving strategy to secure the win. And getting a fourth place. If anyone wants to donate to remove the troll and replace it by me, feel free. Both CGN and Wouter have had their encounters. Daniel usually too dominant to be bothered. He knows when to pull off those 360s, having a lot of experience. Wouter just goes straight through him. Good stuff. Good stuff. Daniel having the balls to risk the dive, getting the fourth place as a result. That's the dynamics of this run. You can't take that amount of risk sometimes. Wouter still close. Whiteland 1, is a track where it's a debate between jumper and slider. Wouter go for jumper. CGN going for... CGN again being the ballsiest player out here, actually. We'll see if it pays off. Oh no. No. Daniel also going for sort of an intermediate between the two. Mike says Bloodhawk doesn't want to switch to Zenonita too often, I guess. Off to a flying start. Exhibition part of the stream will be probably 6 hours from now, I have no idea. There will be a sort of a break after this session is over. Oh wow! Shout out to CGN staying on track there! Good stuff! That will be part of the highlight reel for sure. CGN's recovery. Sick shit. Wouter and Daniel engaged in a fierce battle for the first place. Oh! Daniel taking a leaf from Patrick's book and shutting down Wouter. And it's Daniel versus Wessels now in a, a clash of spectrums. Daniel seems to be also a little aware of what pushing means. Poor Wouter suffering not only Patrick's falling but also Daniel now. Yep. Oh, what are you doing? He knew what he was doing. He knew what he was doing. This is hype. Daniel showing how to deal with the troll. Just approach him safely and spin attack. Well, this is actually pretty exciting. Well, Daniel establishing a big gap by knocking off Wouter here. Firefield, well. Firefield, Daniel's baby. Great start from CGN as well, really powerful. Daniel just being the machine. Doesn't know how to pick the asshole he spots, but too much going on at the same time to commentate, actually. Fierce fight for second place between CGN and Wouter. Wouter taking the lead. Wouter got distracted. I think fourth place for Wouter again, and Daniel making a big gap now for the lead. Safely finishing. See Jen dealing with it. Daniel 106, I think normally he would sub minutes, but he had to take a little bit conservative. Being aware of the black smoke. Can Wouter mount a comeback? First set, not halfway through, just about. Shoutouts to CGN performing really well. Wouter off to a rocketing start. But he got launched actually. Oh, this is not looking too good for Wouter. He has to avoid do the spin attack too late. Wouter cannot capitalize on his driving skills because he keeps being killed. He has to play a more conservative strategy somehow. Was it Patrick weer die idee of niet? We have to see the replay who actually killed Wouter in this one. He's the only one guy that seems to be wanting to play nicely, but sportsmanship is not always answered with sportsmanship. Well, CGN is also of the untrolling kind so far. Daniel actually taking a leaf of Patrick's book sometimes, I have to say. A couple of fourth places in a row by Wouter. CGN letting the oh my god fly every time he passes Patrick Wessels. He is afraid, but usually he manages to stay on top of things. Securing that second place, Daniel once again with a victory. Wouter is sour-faced at the moment. Nice finish, CGN. Let's see what the score is at the moment. 45 points. Daniel Zia. Wouter still in second, CGN in third, I believe. The players seem to be dealing with the draw effect in a better way. Wouter victimized though so far. CGN getting a push from Daniel. Excellent dives. Oh! Daniel is actually taking a leaf on Patrick's book with the trolling. And Patrick got shot down by Daniel! Shout out to the SRX players. The revenge of the MFO community on the troll. World champion Daniel's here stepping up to the plate to sort out this mess for the other guys. And can he still get to the victory? CGN in the lead, Wouter in second. He might want to risk skipping the looping in the next lap to secure the victory. Same goes for Daniel, but Daniel's really on low health, risking it all. Risking it all. This guy has balls of steel. Oh wow. Oh. And he's getting away with it. Awesome. Just awesome. Wouter has managed to kill himself in the meantime. He's really in rocky waters at the moment. CGN, can he pull off an impressive win against the beast, Daniel Zia? Or did I just jinx it, ladies and gentlemen? Both on zero health. And things, I think I jinxed it. Yeah, I jinxed it. Shout out to... Oh no! Oh no! Why? At least 3 points by Daniel. flying the flag of the MFO community against Patrick Wessels. Good stuff. CGN with the win. Shout out to CGN. Good race. Very good race. It'll be a sour day if Patrick Wessels actually managed to win a race with his tactics. Oh wow. Revenge from Wessels on Daniel. Yes, this is going nowhere. It's not battle mode. Come on, guys. Can Wouter profit from this? Well, he will, most definitely will, but can he get a win again after a streak of fourth places? Comfortable lead against CGN, but nothing is safe. Wolf just walked into the room. I think you're happy that you're missing on this pursuit. You will not believe what's going on in here if you watch the replay. You'll shake your head in disgust. Lafingo, yeah, good question. Patrick is going for an alternative strategy, knowing he will be outraced. He's trying to kill the opponents on all the tracks. CGN risking. Oh, CGN, why did you take so much risk? Why? I guess he wanted to win, but. Second place for Wessel, so the strategy seems to be working sometimes. Second place for Wessels. Daniel. Yeah, yeah. Massive fraudulence. He's influencing the results of the World Championships. The Whitelands. This is a track where experienced players can die even without trolls. So, we'll see. Daniel in the lead. Wouter, I believe, still in second. Note that he's rarely fought, this is a good point. He doesn't crash because he's just parked on the road. This one time Daniel did manage to shut him down, but oh, Wouter, poor Wouter, fourth place. Too risky strategy. All the risks he seems to be taking are smacking him in the face at the moment. CGN worried where Patrick might be located at the moment. He could be called the camping equivalent of a racer. Daniel with a little conservative strategies. Well, my eyes are sewn shut. My mouth is fixed. That's not conservative at all. What time did he get? 57 seconds sub minute, easy. Patrick now complaining that the game engine is not rewarding his trolling. Come on. Route 23. A track where experienced players can sometimes be punished with a jump to a bar glitch. This is Carnage, the final stream of NLG. All players have already made some bloopers. Jump play glitch for Daniel. Wouter profiting and taking the lead. Though also a bit of a mistake from Wouter there. Close. Will these players risk getting screwed over by the jump plate, or will they adapt the strategy so that the glitch does not occur as often? The answer is Daniel's risking it all. Going balls out. Wow. The troll playing no part in this game because they're constantly flying actually. Daniel doing a 360 on the fly, still keeping full speed. Shout out to Daniel. You will rarely see a sicker racer than this guy. Crazy performance. Crazy performance. Wouter, good second place. 6 seconds behind. Patrick's going the wrong way. See Jen surviving. Getting what he deserves. He's smiling though, he's really enjoying this. Not sure if the other guys are enjoying it as much, but hey. Daniel is indeed very impressive, yes. By the way, donate if you are flabbergasted by this proceeding so far. I know I am. CGN pulling off the best dive. First place CGN, Daniel. Not sure what he did there. Was that a troll or a self-destruction? Self-destruction. Wouter approaching CGN. This is an excellent track for trolling actually, so beware. Wouter hitting a bomb. Don't think he wanted that. CGN in the lead, flying the flag for Norway. Wouter for Holland. Patrick Bessel's definitely not flying the flag for Holland. He is just in this for the kills. Playing a bit of GoldenEye in F0X. CGN, good stuff, good stuff. Impressive performance. Can Wouter get it? A tier? Wouter's. No. Oh, wow. Some interaction at the dive. CGN getting some really good dives today. Well, maybe he does it consistently, I don't know. I haven't seen him play F0X that much. He is definitely not a walkover. That's what today has proven, for sure. Oh! Note that this is just Wouter. Wouter wasn't trolling, he just hit CGN at full speed. Getting that win. 63 points. Daniel far in the lead. Wouter in second, CGN in third. Patrick in fourth, but Patrick is raking up points, believe it or not. This time, I think CGN again on the receiving end of the proceedings. Well, I think the simple answer to that would be that the other three guys are far, far more skilled than F0X, so the only chance he stands actually at getting points is trying to kill them. And it's working out. I think without trying that strategy, he would have far less points. Shout out to Frostbeule. Oh, Wouter. Aye. That's a shame. Yeah, he is replacing Westy. I think Westy would have been a more serious contender. Daniel securing the win. CGN not too far behind, once again. K Can I see what the score is between CGN and Wouter for a sec? 46 versus 41, so this is really close. This is really close. Space plant. Another track where space flying dives are the order of the day. If you're tuning in just now, this is the F0X World Championships versus Daniel actually preferring. Oh wow! Oh wow, Daniel trying to be smart and waiting for. The world champ just controlled by Patrick again, of course. Beginning of the race. No. No. Patrick will be fourth. Yeah, that was noted on the stream earlier as well. He is not getting many forwards. Wouter's solid flying. Smooth sailing. He's been playing for appearance lately. So his conservative strategies. A little more conservative. I mean, this. If you're watching this, you're of course thinking this guy is gung-ho crazy, but his time trial driving is much more on the edge. Daniel actually making the strategical decision to wait at the beginning of the race so we could take them over safely. But then, on the ramp, he got taken out. Patrick, second place. Wouter just needs to keep it together now, otherwise Patrick might just get his very first win. Oh dear. May the F-Zero gods prevent this from happening. Wouter flying the flag for the MFO community right now. The pressure is on your shoulder, son. The smile from Wouter, securing his victory. Rival Daniel getting the fourth place. Patrick second place. Off. CGN got trolled? No, Daniel got trolled. I think.
Yeah,
both of them even, okay. Oh dear. People in the stream on this chat are loving this though. It is good entertainment, I'll give them that. Sometimes for the wrong reasons, usually for the right reasons still. Thankfully. Daniel, again waiting at the start, seems to be the new strategy for him. He's so skilled that he can take them over at full speed later, with less risk. Gotta admit that that strategy is actually clever. Wouter in the lead. Daniel second, CGN following in third. Patrick in no man's land, of course. Oh wow, this is some nice driving from all drivers. Can Wouter beat Daniel on pure racing skills? We will see. Stay tuned. Ai. Oi. Out from the lead. Daniel in second, right behind him. Half a second delay between the two. What a race. What a race. Aye. Oh no. Daniel took the lead. Very good race between the two rivals. Uh oh. Wow, yeah. Death finish by Daniel. Wouter having some scary moments at the end there. Could have just as easily been a fourth place. CGN got hit as well, I think, but third. Patrick the Golden Troll. Port Town 2. Does Vessels actually play as Zero-X? Or is he just a random replacement? Now, I think neither. I'm not sure. I'm not sure how he ended up in here. I'll take the blame for this one. I suggested it actually. I'm gonna wake up screaming in the night for doing so now. Daniel, what the hell are you doing, son? It looked like he died, but I know it's positive, but it didn't. Wow. Well, it's risky. It's risky. Is he getting the checkpoint glitch? Serious floating from Daniel, indeed. I have to say, it is definitely entertaining. I am having a blast here, actually. Daniel entering the lap with sickening speed. Oh, oh. Screwed it up. There goes the advantage of the floating. This matches everything. Floating, trolling, gliding, killing. I actually lost track of Vessel's location. Oh, wow! Wow! Oh my f- That was the ma- I've never seen a kill like that. I've never seen kills like that. What the hell? Wouter is fuming. He was winning this one. Have to pay attention. Daniel actually... Daniel taking Vessels on for the kill. Applause for Vessels from the stream here. What a kill that was. Double kill, both guys. C-Gen and Wouter were rocketing at speeds unheard of. Daniel trying to take care of business. Kill him, Daniel. You can do it. Do it for the world. Don't get killed, though. Please don't get killed. Just win, actually. Just win. Are you sure about this, Daniel? You could give Vessels the first win. You can just finish the race. Maybe. Don't let the troll win, Daniel. Seems to be enjoying this, actually. Oh, 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 oh! But now we're in trouble. Reverse for the booster zone, reverse for the booster zone. Don't let him win. This is an unorthodox turn of events. Get the boost and run it safe home. Phew. Yeah, Clark, you're not gonna believe it if you're just turning in. It was one pixel away from Patrick Vessels claiming his first win. Shenanigans is the right word. Phew! Question? Yeah, sure. Normally. Daniel thinks, I think he does do that sometimes. Wouter is usually, I'm not sure, more gentleman in the racing. But I've seen Daniel knock people off before, if applicable. But at least he's good at racing as well, so. Hey, it's just a bit like SMK, I guess. You have to take your chances. That was the highlight of the NLG so far, maybe. Jesus. In the wrong way, maybe. Daniel was actually participating in the trolling, yes, indeed. Also, uh-oh. Well, this track is actually intended for this type of tactics, I'm pretty sure. So. But can we see some proper racing later as well, please? C-Gen in the lead. Daniel in second. Daniel! Oh dear. Your answer here, Yngwie. They are actually killing each other as well. Maybe that's the virus. That's Wouter. Now, Daniel actually shut down CGN there. Wouter in the lead. Wouter is being sandwiched by two trolls at the moment. The world champion
and the opposite.
And the opposite end of the spectrum. Oh wow. Poor Wouter. I'm rooting for Wouter on this one, I guess. Daniel. Close to Wouter and still take the win. Here we go, final lap. Oh wow! Nice dodge by both guys. Props at full speed. Daniel having a little more health. This does not look too good for Wouter. Will he get killed? Yes, he will. And then Patrick gets another second place. Dear me. Dear me. I'm really happy we have a second set here because this is so much fun, actually. No, no, no. Daniel's learned from his lessons. Almost died last time. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Body is an actual stat in the game.
Patrick's got the tank.
Patrick's got the tank, yes. Okay. Daniel on the lead so far, second. I think Wouter is the second, still. You're third, thank God. By a fair margin. Patrick changing the dynamics of this game, and we're going again. It's we go on, right? Yeah, yeah, it's just two full course sets, and yeah, but this we're gonna add up all the scores. Yeah, so you're just in the lead now. We'll just play every track twice. Yeah. No, not backwards. Just one more set. Okay, guys, good luck. No X Cup today. Maybe in the encore stream. X Cup is a random track generator, and it sometimes spawns bullshit tracks. I don't know. Donations for X Cup. If you want to see X Cup, then we can extend this tournament a little bit with one more X Cup. Someone has one donation, we'll extend this to an extra X Cup at the end. We're off for the start. Now all three pro players are aware of the dangers lurking in this set. Let's see how they deal with it. Wouter taking a comfortable lead, Daniel second, CGN third. Very fast opener. 29 opener from Wouter, who got a little boost, I think, if I saw it correctly. A little boost from an opponent, not sure which one. You might, yeah, good dodge, good presence of mind, adapting to the changed circumstances of this versus run. Just do not get killed out there, that's the main thing you have to be sure of. I was heading for a good run. Getting that Mute City win. First win of the first set, of the second set, Wouter Janssen. 15.05 was the 121, that's not even far from the world record, is it? Yeah, I know. He got a rocket boost with the fastest opener ever. You cannot do that in time trial, but this is shenanigans, really. Who gave you the boost? He doesn't even know. Who to thank? It wasn't Patrick though. He doesn't usually give positive boosts. Okay, Silence it is. Last time at Silence, CGN and Daniel got killed in the final lap. They know what will... It won't happen again, I think, yeah. We will not fall for the same trick twice. People on the stream are saying Vessels needs to get a win. All for me disagree. Did we get a donation for X-Cup? I'll check in a sec. So, Carla, what do you think of the tournament so far? And Patrick's role in this? Are you disgusted by it, or do you accept that this is part of today's antics, just by chance? I'm a little in the middle, I'm not sure what to think, actually. CGN having an excellent silence so far. Daniel taking over, though. Vessels. He does bring a unique element, yes. Oh well. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Wouter got eliminated. Poor Wouter. Fourth place, Daniel with the win, 1800 kilometers an hour, shout out to Daniel, 86 points. CGN just needs to make sure that he does not die a lot this set, then he will be home free. He can actually still rival Wouter for the second place. Daniel is beasting indeed. I'm not so sure, Lafango. I'm really not so sure. It does add a new element, but... I think this would have been, skill-wise, a lot more interesting if Vestu showed up, but... Wouter in the lead. CGN, was he trolled? Yeah, he got trolled, of course. By two players, even. Daniel and Patrick trolling CGN. Oh, can I have one actually? People on the chat are at least not regretting Patrick's participation. Oh well. Daniel in the lead. Wouter in second. CGN just needs to make sure he finishes this. Oh, Daniel, risky with the health management, yeah, too risky, oh, wow, Wouter getting trolled two times already in this cup. CGN, the pressure's on your shoulders, son. People on the stream are shouting for Vessels to get CGN, but fortunately, it didn't happen. The FTRX gods are still functioning somewhat. So, their heavens are shaking at the moment. A superbly second place by Vessels, superbly skillful. Zarkov, of course, being the troll he is, can probably appreciate this. Okay, serious phase now, guys. This is for real. Determining the world champion of Asterix multiplayer. You've seen some unexpected developments, but also some kick-ass skills from all drivers. Well, from three of the four, actually. Unless you consider, of course, the art of trolling something that can be considered. Oh wow, Daniel got a speed boost of the Thunder Gods. People are actually giving him trolling advice now. So on port time 1 apparently you should troll at the top of the big jump. This just in. Dani on the lead. Wouter in second, CGN in third. Devils 4-1. Risky health management from CGN. Under these circumstances, health can be a determining factor for points. And the normal order of the day seems to be restored on this track at least. Daniel number 1, Wouter number 2, CGN number 3. Wouter in the start of the second set suffering some severe troll kills, 2 to be precise. I am enjoying this, but well. Come on, guys. Big blue one. Remember to donate for X-Cup if you want to see that happen. One donation will be enough. Dani on the lead. He had a convincing Big Blue 1 win earlier today. Leading CGN by a little less than 2 seconds. Wouter trailing 4 seconds. CGN pulling out all the stops here, ladies and gentlemen. Actually, he lost a bit of momentum there, unfortunately. Not just a bit, but a huge chunk. Players seem to be adapting to the changed circumstances as well now. Big fight between